Hi, folks, and welcome to my monthly update. Wow, there is a lot to talk about, so let's go ahead and get started. First off, do you like my shirt? The missus got me this. She even got one for herself. I think it's awesome. Ewoks rule. Anyway, let's talk about the expandeduniverse.com. Folks, you definitely want to start checking out in the next couple of days because we're going to post a Final Four tournament-like style where all of you can vote every day for your favorite EU character. And we're going to post the results. I don't have the dates right now, but we're going to post the results at certain times and show you who won each round. And by the end of the month or beginning of next month, we are going to crown a champion. Who is the fans' number one favorite character in the expanded universe? Woohoo! StarWars.com has done this for years, but they don't, if ever, put any expanded universe characters. And that always depressed me because I wanted to vote on EU characters. So I talked to Chris. He said we could do it. I came up with a list of 64, or a bunch of us did. We came up with a list of 64 characters from video games, comics, and books. We think we got a good group. You know, we got a well-rounded selection. I won't lie, I threw a few of my favorites in there too. I am cheering for Kip Durin and Walru to win. Also, I'd like to mention that if you are from another part of the world and you are experiencing the same issue that I talked about, I think it was on the last monthly update, about having problems finding Legends material, we'd love to hear from you. It came as a surprise to me that in other parts of the world, Legends reprinted material is really hard to get. And I didn't realize that because it's not as hard here in the U.S. So I know we've had a few people already post their story, and I found that fascinating. I found that so fascinating. I never knew any of that. So if you're someone from another part of the world and you're watching this, you're like, yeah, Matt, I've got a story to tell, then go ahead and email us. Oh, also, if you have an idea for an article for StarWars.com, we always welcome any submissions. I can't promise or say that we're going to post every single one, but, you know, if you have something interesting, then go ahead and pitch it to us at that email address. Now, speaking of that, remember, I'm going to be throwing in Matt Chats. I throw in unique, exclusive videos to the website. I believe it's every Saturday, called Matt Chat. I have several of them already planned out, but if you have an idea for a Matt Chat, you can always let me know. Hey, Matt, why don't you mention this? It's just where I mention a few things, maybe about, usually about the expanded universe, and I do it for about just a couple of minutes. But they're kind of fun to do, and I love doing them for that website, but they are exclusive to the website. You can't see them on my YouTube channel because I show them as unlisted. Moving on to the podcast, let's talk about Saturday Morning Santa Flange. Well, on the previous podcast, we had kind of joked about going to a Western Sizzler. And, you know, lo and behold, we did it. The missus and I drove an hour and a half up to Arkansas, Monticello, Arkansas. It was the closest Western Sizzler we could get to. And in little town of Monticello, Arkansas, we pulled into the Sizzler and ate and had a fantastic time. We did the podcast right there at our table. And so you get to hear it. We even included the waitress for a few minutes. She's on it. So it was really fun to do. A little noisy, but it was still a really fun podcast. You don't want to miss it. And then after that, someone on my live Q&A, I want to say my last one, gave me a great idea for a Saturday Morning Santa Flange, and it was that me and the missus give our top five Disney songs. So that is coming up. I can't remember who that was, but if it was you, you're going to get that podcast later on this month. And folks, if you have an idea for a Saturday Morning Santa Flange, a top five whatever, then go ahead and let me know in the comments. If it's something I haven't done before, or something that we think is interesting and doable, then we'll definitely make that the topic of one of our next podcasts. Now, switching over to Princes of the Universe, Chris from the expandeduniverse.com is going to be joining me, and we're going to talk about everything and anything EU. Now, it's kind of funny because me and Chris can talk, and we basically talk for 2.5 hours. You're only going to get about 50 something minutes of that conversation. The first time we talked, my stupid software wasn't working. So, and I was getting the cheap kind anyway. So I went ahead and bought the nice kind and then had him back on. And we talked about, honestly, I want to say it was 98% different things than what we talked about the hour earlier. And we even, we were even talking for 30 minutes prior to it, and it was great stuff, and I didn't have it recorded. So man, Chris just has so much knowledge and so many interesting thoughts and insights into the expanding universe. I really hope you don't miss that podcast. I think it was fantastic. Now, don't worry. Bruce is coming back on the podcast, and we're going to be reviewing A More Civilized Age. That was the third Sequart book, and this one focused on the expanded universe novels. Of course, I submitted an article to it, and I'm going to give you my thoughts on it. I read it like the week it came out, but I wanted to wait a little while for everyone else to get a chance to read it before I did a whole review. Is it really spoilers? Should I say that? I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to kind of give you just my thoughts on each article, what I found interesting, what maybe I didn't like. I'm going to be brutally honest as always, but I am going to review that book. I've done that for the last two Sequart books, and you know I love them. So anyway, you don't want to miss that podcast as well. And let me think. There was one other thing I wanted to mention. Oh, yeah, I hit 3,000 subscribers this past week. Hey, thank you so much. You know, I say this every time I pass the 1,000 mark, that I'm blown away. I was blown away when I hit 100 subscribers. I was like, what? And people just keep posting just awesome comments, like thanking me. Folks, thank you. I'm a guy that sits around in his room and talks about his favorite hobby, and the fact that you're going to give me some time out of your day, man, that means a whole lot to me, okay? That's really cool. And like I said, I never refer to you as fans. I refer to you as friends, because I have a feeling if I got to meet some of you, I have gotten to meet. And when I get to meet you, I'm like, dude, we would have been good friends back in the day. I had that feeling. Everyone I meet, I'm really happy to get a chance to meet them. And hopefully, as I travel here and there, hopefully I'll get to meet even more of you in the years to come. But honestly, you're like friends to me. You like the same things I do. And even if you don't like the same books I do, or you hate the books that I love, that's fine too. Everyone seems very civil on the channel, very mature. As you know, the internet can be very immature, but on my channel, I really don't see that anymore. You know, I saw the occasional EU hater, but they kind of left a long time ago. So as a way to say thank you, I'm going to do something unique with the number 3. Oh yeah, I know. We're going to do 3 board game reviews and 3 Matt's Expanded Universes for the whole week, starting this week, actually, and then going on for the whole month. So you're going to get ready, because we're going to get a lot of videos Monday through Saturday. Woo! I have been trucking it trying to get these reviews out, and now I just got to edit a few of them, but they're mostly ready to go, and I can't wait. This is the way I celebrate and say thank you to you, so expect 3 Matt's Expanded Universes, 3 board game reviews for the 50 people who watch them. So this week, I'm not going to do Matt's Expanded Universe. I am going to review both Ewok movies. 2 Ewok movie reviews, something I've been wanting to do for a long time. And yeah, I was saving till we hit 3,000. What happens when we get to 4,000? I don't know. How about Matt's Expanded Universe t-shirts? Okay, folks, I hate long videos, and this has gone on way too long here. So I will see you a whole lot in the month of March. See you later.